Such majesty. Much wow.
Iggy, look, yeah, you like that, bud? Victory puppies. Oh, and he caught it.
You got to do good listening today, okay? You got to do... Whoop. Yeah.
Hey, everybody. I wasn't going to do a scrimmage for the blue and white game on account of it's just a scrimmage, but enough of you asked for it that I'm going to do an impromptu one at the dog park. It's slightly chilly and hazardous, but I brought my spikes, so we good. Obviously, last night, like a bunch of you, I watched the blue and white scrimmage, so I decided to ask for some questions on Twitter and comments, and here's what you sent me.
Did you see Nylander, Marner, Robertson, and Lettinen's Super Saiyan aura? Hi, Omar.
Actually, the energy I'm feeling right now is a lot more Arendelle. Hope you appreciate this. I feel like an idiot. So listen, I was watching that game or that scrimmage or whatever you want to call it, and I was like, no, I will not get myself too worked up. I will not draw conclusions based on a scrimmage. And it kind of did a little bit. Nylander obviously had the two goals, and one of which was a bomb. Nylander showed a couple new tricks that we didn't know he had. We know he can carry the puck. We know he can bang in some greasy ones. But the tip-ins were ones we didn't really see a ton of, and one-timers. I'm trying to remember slap shots. Marner is obviously a staple of the power play and the penalty kill and everything. We know he's going to be in there. Lettinen really surprised me. We'll talk more about him later. But Robertson's shot seemed to be the talk of Leafs Twitter afterwards. And what's funny is we all seemed to care more than he did. He didn't even seem happy with it. And I was reading Chris Johnston's write-up on Sportsnet.ca this morning, and he mentioned that Robertson isn't even penciled in on the second power play unit. He was actually a placeholder for Jason Spezza in this one. But it does offer some hope, because this Leafs team, you know, we always talk about offense, but the identity was depth. That's what helped the Leafs do such a good job against Washington in the playoffs in 2017. Oh, they're deep. They can roll four lines. And then as time went on, they still had roughly the same cast. Kapanen and Johnsson are guys playing on their third line, sometimes even fourth, but they didn't produce. I mean the third and fourth lines, not those guys specifically. And then if you're a team built on offensive depth and you don't actually have it, then you have no identity. So if these guys can be part of it, all of a sudden, the Leafs have an identity and they're rolling again.
So to answer your question, yes, I felt the aura.
Iggy feels the Zoomies aura. Let's go.
If you were a goalie, would you dive out of the way if Nick Robertson had a clean shot on you?
Yeah. I would only dive out of the way if I felt like I had a decent chance of stopping it, which I wouldn't. Then again, if he aimed directly for my head, who would blame him?
So you think I'm a defenseman, huh, you piece of...
And then I have a headache.
What went through your mind the first time you saw Jumbo Joe and the Wayne train hop over the board as Leafs?
Holy puck, is this wrong?
But holy hell, is it erotic?
Seriously, it took a minute to get used to. Bogosian was weird, too.
VC, there were a bunch of weird ones. Simmons is one I've been envisioning for a very long time, I suppose, and we got to see a sneak peek of him a few weeks ago. Jumbo Joe, it's surreal. It's surreal because I didn't even realize how huge that guy is. He's huge, he's faster than I thought he would be. Did he look like an absolute all-star? No, but I don't really think anybody did. It was a scrimmage, and no one's had any exhibition time. But the most important thing with Jumbo Joe is he was keeping it loose. He really looks like he's going to improve the mood of the team, which there were so many games where you're like, you're the better team. What's going on? And they just didn't really seem to be enjoying hockey. Hopefully he can bring that love back.
Iggy, let's go this way.
How did my guy Arendelle look? Do you like his pads?
Well, I got bad news. You might have to change them.
Well, I'm not going to lie to you. He didn't look amazing, but I'm not really sure any of the Leafs' goalies did, guys. I think he allowed the most goals. I noticed him moving around the most, but again, these guys haven't had any practice. Like, this is going to be a sloppier start to the season than normal, and that goes for absolutely everybody. To me, it's a pure season because, as we saw in 2013, all that means, you know, the sloppy start, the fewer games, it's not going to mask the good teams. It's actually going to bring them out even more. Is that a mask?
Ew.
Where was I? Anyway, Chicago won like two dozen straight games in the 2013 season. We're going to see someone who's really, really strong do the same this year, I think. But as the season progressed, they eventually lost and they get to the playoffs. And yeah, they won the cup, but they had to fight for it. The New Jersey Devils losing Corey Crawford is huge. He's such a good goalie, and I really thought a tandem of Mackenzie Blackwood and Corey Crawford, that changes the outlook of the Devils entirely. Now, all of a sudden, they're scrambling. They still have Blackwood, who's very good, but who's behind him. Maybe by the time this video is uploaded, they will have claimed Hutchinson, and that answers all the questions, but I just don't know. Aaron Dell's got so much experience, and he was the backup for the Sharks last year. If he goes on waivers, I think he's going to New Jersey.
How great was it to hear Joe Bowen call a game on TV again?
It's cool, and it was the perfect environment for him, you know? A lot of people are like, get him on national broadcast. Guys, I think a lot of fan bases would not have the stomach for that. And to that, you might say, well, who cares? And I would say, them. They care. He's on the radio. He does an amazing job in the radio. And he did an amazing game in this one. He did such a good job. He knows the team inside and out. I will say I missed Paul Hendrick dearly. But there were some friendly faces who got an opportunity on the broadcast who I was just so happy to see. Todd Crocker, you'll know, is the voice of the Toronto Marlies. He was in there doing, like, ringside reporting. But there was this funny moment where he's interviewing Mitch Marner, who's on the bench. And you could see Marner over his shoulder, but, like, on the other side of the rink. And I really enjoyed seeing the in-arena hosts, Danielle and Scott, hosting and getting to do their thing on TV. Those guys work so hard. Like, that's a tough gig. And they do it in front of a building of 20,000 people on most nights. So I'm sure this whole year has been an adjustment for them. And to see them get this opportunity felt really good.
All right, do we think this is safe to skate on?
Goaltending controversy. All right, fine. Let's get to the goaltending controversy.
Well, I think with Aaron Dell, there isn't one. Jack Campbell is the backup. The controversy is people don't seem to think he's even the backup. He's better than Frederik Andersen. The Leafs should go with him as their number one. Guys, beware of new toy syndrome. Jack Campbell's great. Jack Campbell is solid. Jack Campbell's a great guy and a great teammate by all accounts. And he stops pucks. I appreciate that about him. But he has not been an NHL starter yet. If he gets the opportunity, and maybe he'll earn it, and maybe Freddie will give it to him by not being very good, wait for that to come. I know some people are hot on Frederik Andersen and some people are cold. You gotta give him the opportunity to lose that net. If there is a goaltending controversy, it wasn't because of last night.
Is there a way Patan makes the opening night roster?
Sorry, this is just really pretty and scenic. I wanted to stop for a sec. No. I saw a lot of people... Hey, Yiki. Saw a lot of people complimenting Travis Boyd on his game. I thought Patan had a great game, particularly in the first period, but it was just so familiar. He does a lot, and it looks good, and what does it lead to? And the answer in this one was nothing. And sometimes it looks like something, and maybe it is. It's got to go in the net. If you look at his numbers, he is obviously ridiculously good, and the AHL is probably beneath him. Like, he's an elite AHL player. I think he deserves a shot in the NHL. I just don't know how he makes the opening night roster. To me, he seems like an ideal taxi squad player. But again, you got guys like Robertson. You got to have some defensemen back there. Sandin. Like, it's a really difficult decision. I think he... He's 50-50 to even make the taxi squad to me.
Thoughts on Joey Andersen in limited viewings?
Yeah, that's tough because there are so many faces and so many new ones, and you're trying to form an opinion on them based on the, I don't know, 5-6 shifts that you caught during a scrimmage. Joey Andersen, I'm not going to lie, I didn't notice much, but when I did, he was getting in people's faces. And I noticed that a lot about the new guys. Barabanov wasn't really there to make friends. Lettinen, I noticed that a little bit of, but Joey Andersen got into, like, a pretty nasty little fight in front of the net with Rasmus Sandin, and I love that. He's here to make the team. I should say, nasty by the standards of a scrimmage with your own team.
Who surprised you more, Boyd or Mikko?
Mikko Lettinen, for sure. The expectations are so high for him that I thought he would disappoint, whereas Travis Boyd comes in, and a lot of Leaf fans forget he even signed. But Turns out he's a pretty good player. Looks like a strong candidate. Probably not to make the opening night roster, but maybe be an extra or on the taxi squad. Mikko Lettinen, though, he looks ready. Like, I don't know how much of an adjustment there's going to be. He looks ready now. And that surprised me. Like, I thought there would be some confusion, but he's been skating here for a while. And turns out he's pretty good at hockey.
You want a stick? Is it time to stop talking?
All right, everybody. So that is it for this one. Thank you very much for watching. I already lost the stick.
Thank you very much for watching. Click like if you like this video. Click subscribe if you really liked it. Tell all your friends and leave a comment in the comment box down below. What did you think of the players in yesterday's blue and white scrimmage?
You want to be part of the screen where people click on stuff? You want it? No? No? Look at this. Yeah, this is why I brought spikes.